students of the center who are working as assistant professor in the department of microelectronics in MBR college of engineering and technology. In this session we are discussing about the fused power based fusion metals, power based fusion metals, and this is the cause of the cause of the 3D printing which is used in the material extrusions and material extrusions and material jetting. If you see this is the different types of 3D printing. First is a material extrusion of FDM used to deposition manufacturing materials, and next is VAT polymerization SLA DLP, power bed fusion polymers like SLS, and a material jetting of DOD, binder jetting and the power bed fusion metals. Okay, power bed fusion metals. And this FDM or a fused filament fabrication is an additive manufacturing process that belongs to the material extrusion family. In FDM, an object is built by selection depositing melted material in a predetermined path layer by layer. The materials are thermoplastic polymers that come in a filament form. FDM is the most widely used 3D printing technology. It represents the largest installed base of 3D printers globally and is often the first technology people are exposed to. In this article, the basic principles and the key aspects of the technology are presented. A designer should keep in mind the capabilities and limitations of the technology when fabricating a part with the FDM, as this will help him achieve the best result. Okay, this is the filament based fabrication. It is an additive manufacturing process. An addition process which to the material extrusion family process, and also the thermoplastic polymers are coming a filament form, which is widely used for the 3D printing technologies, or represent the largest installed base of 3D printers globally, and is often the first technology people are exposed to. Okay, a designer should keep in mind and the capabilities and limitations of the technology when fabricating a part with FDM to the best results. Okay, if you see in this diagram, the extrusion part. Okay, the extrusion part of the materials will be slightly extrused through these materials. Okay, if you see in this next diagram, the full material of this part is very extruded with this cone shape of material. Okay, needle shape of the material. After this, in this X shape also it is directly extruded with the different methods of the material. Okay, in this diagram, it is in the extruded part, where the extruded part will be slightly different throughout the materials of the systems. Okay, material of the system. How FDM works. Okay, here is how the FDM of application. What is meant by FDM? FDM is nothing but fused deposited manufacturing process. Okay, a spool of thermoplastic filament is first loaded into the printer. Once the nozzle reaches the desired temperature, the filament is fed to the extrusion head and in the nozzle where it melts. The extrusion head is attached to a three-axis system that allows it to move in the X, Y, Z direction. The melted material is extruded in a thin strands and is deposited layer by layer in predetermined locations where it cools and solidifies. Sometimes the cooling of the material is accelerated through the cause of use of cooling fans attached on the extrusion head. Okay, where the thermoplastic material filament is loaded into the printer, and also the filament is fed into the extrusion head of the nozzle where it melts. Okay, the extrusion head is attached to the three axes like X, Y, Z directions. The melted material is extruded in the strands and is deposited layer by layer in predetermined locations where it cools and solidifies. To fill an area, multiple passes are required, similar to coloring a rectangle with a marker. Okay, when a layer is finished, the build platform moves down or in other machine setups, the extrusion head moves up and a new layer is deposited. This process is repeated until the part is completed. See, to fill an area, this is the area. Area with the multiple passes are required. Okay, multiple passes are required. When the layer is finished, the build platform moves down and a new layer is deposited. This process is repeated until the part is completed. Okay, this is the base platform. This is the platform we are taking, which is the support material. And this support material, this is the part which we have taken, and this is the extrusion head. Extrusion head is where the additional material process which will be taken in this material process. And this is the part of filament, where the filament process will be attached to the support filament. And these two filament, by this process only, the needle will be extruded to this material. And this extruded material will be slowly reduced through the process, or slowly increased through the process, which will be additive to the output of the material. Okay, in this parts of layout of this the main parts of this diagram is first we should have a support material. Okay, to build the platform, we have a support material. In that support material, a part should be fixed, and this extrusion head also will be attached to this materials, and the part filament and also the support filament can be easily identified. And this support filament can be extruded throughout this family, throughout this part filament, and this extrusion head will be attached to the table. And from this needle purpose, the manufacturing process will be passed throughout this support material. Okay, next, characteristics of FDM. Characteristics of FDM is nothing but printer parameters. Most FDM systems allow the adjustment of several process parameters, including the temperature of both the nozzle and the build platform, the build speed, the layer height, and the speed of the cooling fan. These are generally set by the operator. So they should be of a little concern of the to the designer. What is the important from a design perspective is build size and layer height. The available build size of a desktop 3D printer is commonly 200 by 200 by 200 mm. While for industrial machines, this can be can as a big as 1000 by 1000 by 1000 mm. If a desktop machine is preferred, a big model can be broken into smaller parts and then assembled. The typical layer height used in FDM varies between 50 and 400 microns and can be determined upon placing an order. A small layer height produces smoother parts and captures curved geometric more accurately. Okay, while a larger height produces part faster at a lower cost. A layer height of 200 microns is most commonly used. An article discussing the impact of layer height in 3D printed part can be found here. Most of the FDM systems allow the adjustments of the process parameters with the nozzle and also the build platform. The build speed and the layer height and the speed of the cooling fan, these are generally set by the operator. So they should be of little concern to the designer. Which the printer parameters is also the build size and also the layer height. These two are very important, which can be to build a product of industrial machines. This can be as big as 1000 by 1000 mm. So if desktop machine is preferred, a big model can be broken into smaller parts. The typical layer height used in FDM varies between 50 and 400 microns and can be determined upon placing an order. A small layer height produces smoother parts and captures curved geometries more accurately, while a larger height produces parts faster and at a lower cost. A layer height of 200 microns is most commonly used. An article discussing the impact of layer height in a 3D printed part can be found here. Next, wrapping. Wrapping processor. It is one of the most common defects of a FDMR. When the extruded material cools during solidification, its dimensions decreases. Okay, as different sections of the cool at different height rates, their dimensions also change at different speeds. Differential cooling causes the buildup of internal stresses that pull the underlying layer upwards, causing it to wrap up. From a technology standpoint, wrapping can be prevented by closer monitoring of the temperature of the FDM system and by increasing the adhesion between the part on the build platform. The choices of the designer can also reduce the probability of wrapping up. Okay. These wrapping processes are only two types. One is large flat areas, another one is three protruding features. Okay, large flat areas are more prone to wrapping and should be avoided if when possible. Okay, thin protruding features are also prone to wrapping. In this case, wrapping can be avoided by adding some sacrificial materials at the edge of the thin feature. Okay, for example, a 200 microns thin rectangle to increase the area of the touches the build platform. What is meant by wrapping? Wrapping is one of the defects of the FDM processor. Means when extruded materials if is solidified throughout the dimension process that different sections of the material or different sections of the tool at a different rates, the dimension also changes at a different speeds. Differential cooling causes the buildup of internal stresses that pull the underlying layer upwards, causing it to wrap up. From a technology standpoint, wrapping can be prevented by closer monitoring of the temperature of the FDM system. Okay, and by increasing adhesion between the part of the build platform. The choices of the designer can also reduce the probability of wrapping up. Okay. It is one of the most defects of the FDM, which can be identified throughout the process of the materials. Next, large flat areas. Large flat areas are more prone to wrapping and should be avoided when possible. Okay, thin protruding features are also prone to wrapping. In this case, wrapping can be avoided by adding some sacrificial materials at the edge of the thin features. Okay, to increase the area to touch the build platform. And this is the most important extruded materials of the solidifies its dimension decreases. Okay, and also the wrapping can also be monitoring the temperature of the FDM systems and also by increasing the adhesion between the part and also the build platform. Where the large flat areas can also be reduced to this prone of wrapping should be also possible to throw the materials of the sections. Okay, material of the sections. And also this thin protruding features are also prone to wrapping. In this case, wrapping can also be added throughout the material of the sections. Okay, next, sharp corners are wrapping more often than rounded shapes. So adding fillets to the design is good practice. Okay, different materials are also susceptible to wrapping. ABS is generally more suitable to wrapping compared to PLA or PETG due to its higher glass transition temperature, relatively high coefficient of thermal expansion. Okay, if you see in this diagram, this is a shrink material. It is a wrapping processor which causes throughout the materials. Okay, next, this is the base material. Okay, this is the base material which we will support to this wrapping processor. Okay, this is a material which it is a wrapping, slowly wrapping depend upon the material sections. Okay, and also the sharp corners are wrapping more than often than rounded shapes. So adding fillets to your design is a good practice. Different materials are more susceptible to warping. ABS is generally more susceptible to warping compared to PLA due to its higher glass transition temperature, relatively high coefficient of thermal expansion. Okay, next, layer adhesion. Layer adhesion is nothing but good adhesion between the deposited layers is very important for an FDM part. Okay, when the molten thermoplastic is extruded through the nozzle, it is pressed against the previous layer. The higher temperature and the pressure remains the surface of the previous layer and enables the bonding of the new layer with the previously printed part. Okay, the bond strength between the different layers is always lower than the base strength of the material. Okay, this means that the FDM parts are inherently anisotropic. Their strength in the z-axis is always smaller than their strength in the xy plane. For this reason, it is important to keep a part orientation mind when designing parts for FDM. Okay, for example, tensile test pieces printed horizontally in ABS at 50% infill were compared to the test pieces printed vertically and were found to have almost 4 times greater than the tensile strength in the XY print direction compared to the Z direction. Okay. And also the elongated process can also be easily identified through this process material. Okay, moreover, since the molten material is pressed against the previous layer, its shape is deformed to an oval. This means that FDM will always have a wavy surface even for low layer height, and that small features such as small holes or threads may need to post process it after printing. It also the good adhesion between throughout the materials of the section is very important for an FDM part. Okay, when the molten metal or molten thermoplastic is extruded throughout the nozzle, it is pressed against the previous layer. The high temperature and the pressure remelts the surface of the previous layer and enables throughout the bonding surface of the materials. Okay. Already we know that the layer adhesion process. The adhesion process is nothing but extra material we are adding to the product. Okay, and means layer by layer. Okay, when the layer by layer we keep that layer by layer, the viscosity will be adjusted throughout the materials. And throughout the materials in the X, Y, Z directions and on X, Y, Z plane axis, which is directly throughout the materials of the designing parts of FDM. Okay, the tensile test pieces are also printed horizontally throughout the section of the materials, which it can be directly in XYZ direction materials, and also the elongated material parts can also be easily identified throughout the process material. And also, since the molten materials is pressed against the previous layer, is shaped to an deformed to an oval pattern. This means that the FDM process can be easily identified throughout the wavy surface of the lower height materials, lower layer height materials, and the small features of the materials such as small holes or threads can be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. Okay, if you see in this diagram, it has a layer by layer process. Layer by layer process with a different radius and also different types of their edges. Notches can also create stress concentration at the layer interfaces. Means layer by layer means where the viscosity is easily identified throughout the process of the materials, and also the radius also should have a curved part which is correctly mentioned or correctly identified through this process. Okay, this is a layer and layer adhesion process. If you see in this diagram, if the curves are also layer by layer, and this layer by layer can be used or can be easily extruded through the FDM process only. And this FDM process correctly, where the radius of the dimensions can also be easily identified throughout the process of the material. Next, support structure. Support structure is an essential for creating geometries with overhangs in FDM. Overhangs in FDM. The melted thermoplastic cannot be deposited in air. For this reason, some geometries require support structure. A detailed article explaining the use of support structure can be found here. Surfaces printed on support will generally be of lower surface quality than the rest of the part. For this reason, it is recommended that the part is designed in such a way to minimize the need for support. See, support structures is nothing but if you are taking the FDM process. FDM process means that the thermoplastic can are also deposited throughout the materials. And the support structure is very pillar is very required to be a pillar like an product which is easily identified throughout the process of the materials. And this lower surface quality material can also be recommended throughout the part sections of the designed process. This support is usually printed in the same material as a part. Support materials that dissolve in liquid also exist, but they are used mainly in high-end desktop or industrial FDM 3D printers. Printing on dissolved supports improves significantly the surface quality of the part, but increases the overall cost of the print as specialist machine are required, and because the cost of the dissolvable material is relatively high. And this surface materials can also be easily identified throughout the surface quality, which can be minimized throughout the support of the materials. And this can be support materials can dissolve in a liquid also exist, but they are used mainly in a high-end desktop or industrial FDM processor. And in the support structures is mainly used throughout the material of the purpose. Next, infill and shell thickness. Infill and shell thickness is nothing but the FDM parts are usually not printed solid to reduce the print time and save material. Instead, the outer perimeter is traced using the several passes called the shell, and the interior is filled with an internal low density structures called the infill. Infill and shell thickness affect greatly the strength of a part. A guide for choosing the best shell and infill parameters for FDM 3D printing can be found here. For the desktop FDM printers, the default setting is 25% infill density and 1 mm shell thickness, which is good compromise between strength and speed for quick parameters. And also the FDM parts are also usually not printed solid to reduce the print time and save material. Instead the parameter is traced during the several passes called the shell. And also the interior filled material with an internal part and also low density structures called the infill and shell thickness have to be greatly the strength of the part. A guide choosing the best shell and infill parameters for FDM 3D printing can be found here, which is the default setting of the 25% and 1 mm shell thickness, which is good compromise between the strength and speed of the thick printers. Okay, this is the three different materials which are using in the FDM processor. Means one is the dimensions and the diameters increased, and one is the layer by layer thickness is decreased, and also the net process materials can also be easily identified throughout the processor. Okay, this is the one of the 3D printing machines. 3D printing machines, if you see in our department also, this 3D printing machines is available. We can see any FDM process or any FDM through programming FDM process materials can be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. This is the FDM process which can be easily identified, and how the FDM process is different types of materials can be used support structures of the material systems. Okay, the layer by layer can also be easily identified between the different types of FDM processes can easily identify throughout the process materials. Okay, this is the process of the FDM, how FDM and extruded materials can be used throughout the printing material, throughout the process of the materials. And this material extrusion process can be easily identified throughout the process materials. And this powder bed, and this material extrusion and the vat polymerization and the material process can be easily used by using the 3D printing technologies, and also it represents the largest installed base of 3D printers globally, and is often throughout the first technology people are to be exposed. Okay, a designer should also keep a very keen observations of the layer by layer which we are doing, and also the way the viscosity is to be increased from the material of the sections. Okay, and this FDM process is used due to the thermoplastic filament, and also the first loaded printer depend upon the nozzle of the desired temperatures, and which the extrusion part is slowly decreased throughout the material purpose. And this extrusion part is attached to a three-axis materials or three-axis system that allows it to move the X and Y and Z directions. The melted material are also extruded with a thin stamps, and is deposited layer by layer is predetermined locations, and it cools and solidifies throughout the material processor. Okay, to fill an area, the multiple passes are required throughout the sections of the materials. Okay, in this filament areas, you should build a platform and support material, the part of the extrusion part and the part filament which is to be easily identified throughout the process. And also the characteristics of FDM parameters through the adjustment of several parameters including the temperature of both the nozzle and the build platform is easily determined throughout the process of the materials. Okay, and this the important material can also be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. The typical layer of the height due to the use in FDM process can be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. And this layer by layer height of 200 microns is the most commonly used of an multimeter of impact of layer height in 3D printed part of the materials. Now, vatting is one of the most common defects of the FDM process, which can be extruded material cools during the solidification process of the materials. And also the different sections of the materials can also be easily identified throughout the material of the sections. Okay, and this is the vatting process can be easily identified throughout the choices of the designer, and also the large flat areas are more prone to warping should be avoided when possible throughout the material of the sections. And thin protruding features are also prone to warping throughout the 200 microns of the materials. Sharp corners are warping more often than rounded shapes, so added design is a good practice of the materials. And this is the FDM process which are using in this technology purpose, which we are using by the layer by layer materials. And this layer by layer materials can also be easily identified throughout the material sections of the transition parts. And also the layer adhesion process can also be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. Okay. Where the bond strength between the different layers are also usually identified throughout the base strength of the materials. And also the part orientation materials can also be easily identified throughout the process in the X and Y directions, Z directions. And also the FDM process also, the base height is a 200 mm of each and every corner of the materials. And these sections can also be identified throughout the different types of radius on their edges of the materials. And also the support structures throughout the materials can also be determined throughout the process of the materials of the sections. Okay, the printed materials of the support materials can dissolve in liquid and can also be dissolved throughout the process of the materials. Okay, infill and shell thickness can be determined throughout the course of the materials. If you see these three different types of FDM processor, you can observe what is the difference between these three. See, layer by layer is differentiated between these three layers. Means the netted shell part and also the dimensions is very decreased throughout the process of the materials. Okay. And this layer by layer is very important of the FDM process, which can be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. Okay. And this FDM filament is so producted throughout the materials or throughout the section of the parts. Throughout the section of the parts. After this, the material layer by layer can be easily identified throughout the section, which can be traced under during the several parallel passes throughout the sections, and the interior is filled throughout the internal part of the structure parts. Okay. And infill and shell thickness affect greatly the strength of the part, which is choosing to the parameters of the FDM. Printing can be found here for desktop FDM printers. The default setting is 25% infill density and 1 mm shell thickness, which is a good compromise between strength and speed per foot parameters of the sections. Okay. Next, the support structures are also which overhangs throughout the FDM process, and also the thermoplastic cannot be deposited throughout the section of the materials. A detailed article explaining of the support structures of different surface printed materials can also be easily identified throughout the process of the materials. Okay, this is the FDM process which we are seeing in the second unit, in the last topic of the second unit. In the next class, we will discuss about the powder based manufacturing systems and also the types of powder based and how it works on different specifications, what are the 3D printings which can be used throughout a life process, and also the different types of the powder based manufacturing systems. Okay, we'll see in the next class.